I'm just going to give you guys a brief overview of what Jasmine is and how we are going to be using it in our project. So I'm going to be screen sharing right now. Okay, as you can see, I am in our GitHub repo for our feed reader. So whenever you go into, so you have this master branch where you have a bunch of different folders, index.html, readme, you go into Jasmine, and then you go into Speck, where you see feedreader.js. This is the file that you're going to be writing your test suite in. So as you can see, this file already has some stuff in it. So it has a bunch of documentation, which is really good. You guys have to go through it, since all the tests that you will be writing are listed under to-dos right here. So let me just let me zoom into it. Okay, yeah, so you have all these to-dos. So all these to-dos are what the test that you need to be writing. Mm-hmm. So above that, if you can see, there is one little sort of code that is written, and it's actually written using Jasmine documentation. So what the describe is it's actually just like reading is it's defining a suite, and the name of the suite is going to be RSS feeds. So this is going to be the start of your test suite for RSS feeds, for testing RSS feeds. Mm-hmm. And then you have these documentation here that specifies this is our first test, and it tests to make sure that all feeds variable have been defined and that it's not empty, and you have to experiment with this before you get started with your project. So what happens when you change all feeds in app.js to be an empty array and refresh the page? As you can see, this is what Jonathan was talking about in his last office hours, where he actually deleted the all feeds variable, made it empty, and then he sort of tried running this code, and it failed. So what I'm going to do is the next part, line 24, is it, our defined function. So what it is the it function inside is called a spec. So what is a spec? A spec is a JavaScript function that says what some piece of your program should be doing. So as you can see, RSS feeds need to be defined. That is essentially what you have to do in this code. And it is just a function that's going to define your specs. So a test suite can have a zillion specs that define a zillion tests. The next line when you go is the expect function. So what does the expect say? So the expect function acts on the all feeds variable, and it says to be defined. So you need all the feeds inside your JSON object to be defined, and the length should not be zero. So as you can see, this is very readable. And if you want to explore all these functionalities, the to be defined and to be zero functionalities, what you can do is you can go back to the Jasmine folder and then go into your lib, Jasmine 2.1.2. And when you open jasmine.js, what you can see is I'm going to be searching to be defined. So as you can see, there are four instances. So the first one is actually providing you a matchers. So as you can see, these are called matchers. So whatever goes into your expect, and all these functions are called your matchers. So you go down, and you can see that this is how the to be defined is defined. And it's going to either return, I think, a variable that is going to say, no, is it true or is it false? So that's what it's sort of going to give you. And you have a lot of other functions called to be falsy, to be greater than, to be less than. You can make use of any of these inside your test suite, depending upon what sort of tests you want to act on. So yeah, that was a very quick and short summary. But if you have more questions on P6, feel free to post on the forums, and I'm sure your peers or the instructors will be glad to help you.